very effectively, and he bought himself time. That gave him time for more warpins, and there's another blink as he chases down this Protoss force, relentlessly wearing away at them until finally the Zerg are forced to burrow underground and hide from this very, very dangerous Protoss force. And here comes the Protoss again on the offensive, using a Phoenix, an air unit, to hunt overlords. This is very, very dangerous for the Zerg player as his overlords are hunted and destroyed in the sky. And here comes the Protoss pushing against the Zerg.
So we see a ton of Stalkers moving up into now Yun-Ho Lee's expansion, but there are too many Zerglings. Those Stalkers are not strong enough against enough units that can surround them. They only have Blink, and that's on a 10-second cooldown, so those things are going to get surrounded again because the Zerglings are so fast, and David Kim's assault is thwarted.
Yeah, and you can see just how badly those units were damaged in the previous attack. The Stalkers were quickly surrounded. They couldn't really get away. They couldn't use their speed. Even the Blink was of limited use, and here comes a combo. Here comes a Phoenix and Void Ray combo using the Graviton Beam to pick that Queen in the air. She's floating in there helpless right now from the Graviton Beam, and the Void Ray using his very powerful attack to just power down that Queen. You can see the Protoss are just on the offensive in the air. Meanwhile, the Zerg are on the offensive in the ground, moving in to engage this base. It's a lot of Zealots and a Photon Cannon as the Protoss back up and use that very narrow position, trying to trap the Zerg where they can't get a surround. The Zerg want to wrap around their enemy, but the Protoss want to fight in a narrow frontage, and the Protoss had that advantage there, so the Zerg didn't like it. They moved away, and now they're going to see what kind of damage they can do in what appears to be a fairly helpless Protoss base.
So it looks like David Kim's main base is very, very defenseless at this point. We see a couple of those Zerglings looking to move away from the pack, and oh no, we see a couple of Banelings getting morphed in over on that left side of the map. Meanwhile, all the Zerglings and the Roaches are trying to distract the Protoss units, make sure that he does not get any units over there to attack them, because right now, while those Banelings are hatching, they're extremely vulnerable to any attacks.
That's right, and those Banelings do explode when they get close to the enemy, and here they come, moving in. The Zealots have no defense against things. They don't want to fight them except in small groups.
Oh.
Try to sacrifice a Zealot, but he fails, and here come the moving in.
Oh!
Oh my god! Took out a ton of those probes with those Banelings, and both Photon Cannons are down. What a great use of the Baneling against that Protoss economy.
Now, despite the fact that Yun-Ho did just make it in there with that many Banelings, we can still see that David Kim does have the economic advantage. He has 44 probes out on the field versus Yun-Ho only having 37 drones out there. This is really going to make a difference in the long-term play.
Yeah, he's willing to catch up in his economy. He did a lot of damage. He's helped right a lot of his issues right there and got himself back into sort of an even footing, more or less. But he's going to need to keep building workers if he's going to stay in this game. You can see he's got Banelings there morphing in that hidden area and another expansion. Meanwhile, in the middle of the map, the Protoss player is tearing through those rocks and prepared to make what may be a little bit of a surprise attack on the Zerg.
Ooh, but it's apparently not that much of a surprise attack. I believe that Yun-Ho had an overlord somewhere nearby so that he could see those destructible rocks going down. We see David Kim working through that second destructible rock only a few more seconds, and he'll be able to move into Yun-Ho's base, what he thinks will be freely. He now sees, oh wow, looks like Yun-Ho's going to be tricking him, trying to bait all of those Protoss forces into chasing only his four Roaches, and boom!
Oh, no!
10 Banelings jump up out
of
the ground.
All of those Banelings just took out all of the Zealots, as you can see, only by using force field did he narrowly escape total destruction of his force right there. Still huge amounts of damage done to the Protoss. All of those Zealots taken out. And you can see that, once again, the Zerg are in a really great position here. They've got another expansion going down. There are other expansions working great. And the Protoss player just took a ton of damage from those Banelings.
Up on the resource level, we saw just now that David Kim is still resourcing about double the minerals per minute that Yun-Ho Lee is currently able to gather. So David Kim, over the rest of the course of this game, is likely just going to plain outmass him unless Yun-Ho makes good use of that second expansion.
Yeah, he's really going to have to get that up and running to take advantage of it. And you can see, here we go, moving in again. A couple of Banelings were taken down before they could morph. He's got a few Banelings hit underground. Oh, that's not good for those Nullifiers. Wow, what a ton of damage against those Nullifiers, losing some critical aspects of his force. He's using the Blink Micro, trying to play keep away, but he's just really having a lot of trouble against this persistent Zerg force.
Oh, and here come an Infester. He's coming around over here. They have a Neural Parasite ability, which is that mind control, and we can see a mind control that Immortal, and now he is using David Kim's Immortal to kill David Kim's Stalkers.
And a Stalker is controlled as well. A lot of Queens have been destroyed. That's very important for the Zerg not to lose those Queens, but still, the damage is done. The Zerglings are out. Here comes some more Infestors waddling around the map before quickly burrowing underground. You can see the Stalkers are trying to do some damage, trying to get into the base, see what they can do. It's too many Zerglings, and they're quickly overcome, and another Protoss attack is pushed back by the Zerg.
Ooh, losing three Queens is a really big deal for Yun-Ho at this point, because he really needs to have those out on the field to give him that extra spawn of larva.
Yeah, he really needs that for his economy. It's very, very important. But you can see the Protoss player here is also teching. Oh, here come the Zerg moving in, trying to do some damage, but the photon cannon is going to keep those Zerglings at bay. They can't get the surround on the photon cannon, and of course the probes could join in the fight. And here is the real danger. Colossus are being built on that high ground location by the Protoss. So that's a real threat to this Zerg player.
That's right. David Kim's doing a little sneaky tech up there, building those two robotics facilities and making those Colossus out of anywhere that Yun-Ho was able to see so far. David Kim is gathering out in front of his base, but because those infestors are able to move while burrowed, Yun-Ho knows exactly what David Kim is up to.
Yeah, so he's seen everything that's going on there. He, of course, hasn't seen the Colossus yet. He's been using his scouts on the main base. He doesn't know the threat of the Colossus potentially is even in play at this point, though he could guess. And we can see over here there is a warp prism over here. This is a way that the Protoss player could warp in some additional units. You can see he's hidden it over here for a rainy day, no doubt hoping to just sort of distract the Zerg player and then move in and warp in some additional forces down there. Oh my goodness!
What?
Neuroparasite on the Colossus. The Colossus have been mind controlled, and you can see they've been trapped now using force field. They've been trapped by their own forces, and the Colossus are just destroying the Protoss forces. What a great turn by the Zerg.
Using those Colossus to do terrible, terrible damage to David Kim's own army. We can see the Zerglings are now able to surround those Colossus as they finish off their neural parasite.
What looked like just a brutal, brutal attack by the Protoss was quickly, quickly turned by the Zerg, but you can see the distraction may have worked. While the Zerg were all out in front fighting, there were some additional Stalkers warped in. Meanwhile, this other part of the map, the Protoss are on the attack. They destroyed a Zerg expansion, and it looks like the Zerg are in a little bit of trouble here. They managed to sort of fight back all the threats that are throwing at them, but the economy advantage is really starting to show a key advantage here for the Protoss as they just continue relentlessly attacking. Here the Stalkers just tearing up this Zerg expansion.
So you can see a few infestors and a couple queens come into play. We do see that neural parasite again coming out and surrounding, taking over a couple more stalkers, able to finish off that force. We see the queen is trying to take out the phase prism, but it looks like four immortals warp into play, and there's just not much that Yun-Ho Lee is able to do to stop it.
What a huge force, four immortals. That, and there's the GG. The Zerg player knows that game is effectively done. Good game, he says to David Kim.
What a great game between those two players. We saw some excellent micro between Roaches and Burrow, as well as the Stalkers with Blink.
Absolutely. Thanks, everybody, for joining us for this StarCraft II Battle Report.